What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 32 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. Last time we cleared the Scenewood Gym, we're going to be heading back to Olivine using Pidgeotto's new fly ability. We're going to go ahead and heal up the Ampharos and take on the Olivine Gym. It's going to be so much easier traveling now. So we need to head to the lighthouse first and meet up with Jasmine at the top. Now that we've cleared the lighthouse, we can just take the elevator and take the short way up. Going up. And there's Jasmine and the Ampharos. Hello, Jasmine. We've got a delivery for you. Give over the secret potion. Alright, do what you gotta do. The light! Well, obviously he's feeling a lot better now. Alright, so now the Olivine Gym is ready to go here. Quava's got something in his paws there. And we got some more seals there for our Pokeballs. I think I'm going to demo that if we have time at the end of the episode here. I don't know how long it's going to take me to do the Olivine Gym. However, I do believe in that gym, Jasmine is the only trainer we have to fight. And Baoba's calling us. Okay, the Safari Zone's open now. Alright. Alright, so I think I've got plans for the next couple of episodes. Once we finish here in Olivine, we'll go ahead and check out the new Safari Zone. Alright, time to get down to business. Now, Jasmine uses the Steel type, which is weak against Fighting and Fire. Hence why I have Quilava up front here. These guys at the gym are not going to battle us. Yeah, we're actually going to be able to get two badges in two episodes here. And we're not going to waste any time, let's get right to it. Okay, Jasmine's going to start off with a Magnemite, an electric steel type, worth 1 EV point in special attack. Perfect for Quilava. And a nose Thunderbolt. Hopefully that won't do too much. Ouch. It survived, though. However, that may make one of the next Pokemon a little bit more difficult. Quilava's at level 27 now. Oh boy, this is the one I was afraid of here. Steelix, the evolved form of Onix. Steelix is worth 2 EV points of defense. It's 30 feet long and weighs close to 900 pounds. And not too many weaknesses. I'm basically using Espeon as a shield here. Here comes Iron Tail. That's going to be the move we need to watch out for. That's probably going to KO Espeon one shot. No surprise there. Okay. Let's try Heracross. Good Brick Break should do some damage here, despite him being 10 levels higher than us. Okay, Sandstorm's down to play. That'll last 5 turns and will injure any Pokemon that's not Rock, Steel, or Ground. But Brick Break is doing a little bit of a damage there. We're making some progress. We got down to half HP now. Here comes Iron Tail. Heracross is still alive, but lost a little bit of its defense. Gotta play cautious here. Don't want to risk Jasmine using the Hyper Potion, so that's why I use Rock Smash. Well, Steelix ended up using its Citrus Berry, so that kind of backfired on me. And Rock Throw is going to knock out Heracross. Well, let's try Gyarados. It is Park Ground type. Maybe some Water moves will do good. Maybe even Dragon Rage. Cut its attack with Intimidate. Let's see what Surf does. Pretty good damage. I have a hunch that Jasmine's gonna use a potion here. Yep, my hunch was dead on, as I thought it would be. As long as I avoid Rock Throw, I should be in pretty good shape. Surf actually did some decent damage there. The Sandstorm's gone. Let's bite it. Want to get it down to just under half HP, then knock it out with Surf. Let's see what Dragon Rage does. Missed Iron Tail, so let's take it down with Dragon Rage again. Looks like she only had the one potion, so I think the worst is over at this point. Huge win for Gyarados, and I mean that literally. I mean, Gyarados is my biggest Pokemon at over 500 pounds. It took down a guy close to twice its weight. Just trying to learn Leer here. I'll get rid of Tackle, since that's really not a useful move for me anymore, especially considering the moveset I have. Yep, all she has left is a Magnemite, and I do believe that's only going to be level 30, so now it's safe for Quilava to come out now. So we'll go ahead and make this quick here. Oh boy. That paralysis could be a problem. Let's see if I can get one more fire attack here. Good, it hit Flame Wheel. That's gonna do it. Easy knockout. And we just got badge number 6. And we've got the mineral badge. So now all Pokemon up to level 70 will obey us. We got TM23, which I believe is Iron Tail. Yep. Does decent damage, is a steel type attack, and will occasionally lower defense. He said, a heated battle. I thought I was the bad pun connoisseur here. Anyways, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to head home. Because I want to withdraw money from the First National Bank of Mom. Because I know she's got a lot of money on hand here. She's got about 11K, so I'm going to go ahead and take it all. Before she spends it all on worthless crap. Alright. So I'm heading back to Cianwood. And We're gonna get ready for the Safari Zone. First things first, I'm gonna heal up. See how much time I'm in here. I'm about 10 minutes in right now. Now, I do think there is a route I have to go through before I actually get to the Safari Zone. I'm not entirely sure how long it is, though. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to save that route for the next episode. I'm going to demonstrate the seal case here and decorate some Pokeballs. Okay, so I actually cannot use the seal case. It just tells me how many I have. What you actually have to do is go to your PC, into your PC, and you can go and create ball castles. You can create up to 12. So I'm going to make a few for my Pokemon here. Try and make their Pokeballs unique from one another. I'm not going to do one for Heracross, though. Because it has its own netball that I caught it with. This one's obviously going to be for Quilava. I think I'll leave one just plain. One more. Just got those two left. Party seal and a flora seal. And that's all I can do there. For now. So now I can, set the Pokeballs to a Pokemon. That one's for Pidgeotto. This one will be for Quilava. This I'm going to give to... give it to Gyarados. And this one I'll give to Flaffy. So Espeon will have the plain Pokeball, and Heracross will have the undecorated netball. Alright. So right through this cave, we can see now that the path is open. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. In the next episode, we'll start making our way towards the Safari Zone. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.